Hello, everybody. This is Goombas Are Evil, and welcome to my first review, in which I will be making a review of the original Game Boy, the Game Boy Pocket, and the Game Boy Light. This is a review and a tour of all three of them, so that you guys, if you want to buy them or whatever, you know what's going on with them. So, let's start with the original Game Boy right away. This is the original Game Boy. And on this thing, we got a green and black screen. It is a dot matrix screen, dot matrix with stereo sound. Now you may notice, it only has one speaker. Well, if you were to plug in, say, some headphones, you will get stereo sound. Games were programmed with some stereo sound. So that's that. So there's your dot matrix screen. There's your battery indicator. It's always red, and if the batteries actually run low, it will get dimmer red. So that's how that works. Here's your buttons. A, B, start, select, and a D-pad. Here's your speaker. Here's your headphone jack. I've already showed that. Over here is your contrast dial for the games. Here is the, Nintendo sold adapters that you could plug into here and plug it, your Game Boy into your wall instead of using batteries. Here's your volume control. Here's your, and that's the volume controller for the inbuilt speakers and the headphones. Here's your link cable port, in which the Game Boy can be hooked up to other Game Boys, mainly, to play two players or more. Here is the cartridge slot. Here is the battery cover. Inside here, it takes four AA batteries, and the battery power lasted for 35 hours. This Game Boy came out in 1989. It has some other specs there. You can pause the video quickly if you want to read them all. There you go. And that's pretty much all for the actual hardware on the outside of it. Now, one unique thing about this Game Boy, when you insert a game into it, there is a little switch here. So when you turn on the power button, it will make it so that the cartridge cannot be removed. Because if you remove it, you can have hardware problems with everything. So if you turn it on with the cartridge inside, it will not allow you to remove it. So that's a very handy feature that Nintendo really should have put on all their things, but they didn't. The next Game Boy, they discontinued it. So that's your Game Boy. We'll get to turning it on in a second. I'll show you how it works. Next up is the Game Boy Pocket. This one is a little bit smaller in size than the Game Boy. Actually, a lot smaller, really, for only coming out 7 years later. So this one takes two AAAs, and it lasts for about 10 hours on a full charge, so not nearly as much as you get out of here, but the screen is a lot bit brighter, as you can see. It had a lot better black and white coloring so that you can really see very clearly what's happening on the screen. There's your volume. The link cable port is slightly smaller than the original, so you will need an adapter to connect the two, but you can still play. There is contrast dial again. Here's the power switch. It does not have the little notch. It just turns on and off. So there you go with that. Here's your headphone jack. Here is the adapter again to plug it into the wall. Slightly smaller. And this one came out in 1996. So 7 years later than the original. But what a drastic improvement here. So that's your Game Boy Pocket. Next up comes the Game Boy Light. This one is the rarest of all Game Boys. This one only came out in Japan in 1997, and only about 12,000 were ever made. So very rare if you want to get your hands on them. But they are sold on eBay, new in the box, and used still. You won't find that many, but they are still sold on there. Everything's the exact same as the Game Boy Pocket, except for right here you have two AA batteries instead of two AAAs. This one came out in 1997. You can read the specs there if you want. Yeah, everything's the exact same as the Game Boy Pocket. It even looks the same on all four sides. Of course, mine is a different color. But apart from the fact that the battery cover protrudes out, which a lot of people might find uncomfortable, but it's really not because your fingers fit in there very nicely, the way they fit snug in there together. Now, the other difference is, of course, that the Game Boy Light, so what do you think is going to happen? Well, up here, instead of having two switches on and off, you now have off, on, and on with an indigo backlight. So that was a pretty cool feature that they really probably should have included on some other Game Boys in America, would they? Now that I've covered everything there. Yes. I am going to demo a game in all three of them so that you can kind of see how the screens work and stuff. I have the best light on there as I possibly can, and we're going to look at a classic game here, Donkey Kong. This was a very popular game, came out somewhere in the 1990s, but a lot of people definitely enjoy this, including me. I'm a big fan. I'm on the final boss. I'll show you what the contrast does. For different games, it will go all the way to black like that, and it will go all the way to light, so you can't even see the screen. The best place to have it is around the middle, obviously. So here we are with Donkey Kong, very classic game for the Game Boy, very good game. The first installment of the Mario vs. Donkey Kong series. I'm on file 1, I'm going to send it back to save 0-1 so we can see it right from the beginning. There he is climbing up the ladder. Very ingenious production of these things for only having a black and white screen. You really can see the effects, it's really amazing for its time. It was probably the most popular handheld device of its time. Competitors could not match up to the maximum, I'm going to say, funness of the games. So what we do in this game is we're going to grab a hammer, we're going to jump over the barrel, we're going to hammer it, and the object of the game is to try to get up to the top. And I'm just going to keep hammering these things until it runs out. So I can throw the hammer, I can bring it up here. And the hammer disappeared at the last second, so I could not get up there. So now that you've seen the original Game Boy screen, I'm going to throw it on the Game Boy Pocket, and we'll take a look at that. Nintendo, you can see how much easier the screen is to see. Just the contrast there. It basically does the same thing as the other Game Boy, dark and light. I'll put it right there. That looks good. Bring it back to stage 0-1. There he is climbing up the ladder. He's gonna hammer it down. Very nice sound effects, very nice effects for Game Boy games. They are 8-bit, yes. The screen is square, and it is slightly bigger than the screen on the original Game Boy. Only slightly bigger. And I almost died, wow. Good thing I did not. So now we're gonna head up here, and I died. So hopefully on the Game Boy Light here, I will be able to survive. Nintendo! Yes, here we are with Donkey Kong, again. I will demo some of my other games soon. Let's bring it back to 0-1. You're getting a blue effect from the backlight right now. It is not blue, it is really a much more green color than that. It is very green, that really looks like it's blue. There's no option to adjust the camera or anything to make it look better, but hopefully if you get one of your own, you'll definitely see the difference. I haven't seen any camera anywhere that can actually pick up the green effect. It's very interesting. So yes, you can see this very, very well. So for you guys wondering about it, your eyes are definitely able to see the screen. It is a very, very nice thing to play in the dark. It's easy on your eyes. You definitely won't get headaches or anything. It's a very, very easy to see screen. And I almost got to the top there. So, yeah. There you go with the Game Boy. Thanks for watching, everybody. What do you guys think? What was your first favorite handheld system? How do you like the things? You know, tell me your thoughts about them. Give me a private message, post a comment on the video. Email me, GoombasAreEvil@iCloud.com. The address should be in the video description below. You can send me an email real quick. I'd love to hear your feedback, questions, comments, etc. Whatever you want to say, I will be glad to listen to it and respond to you as soon as possible. Thank you very much for watching Goombas Are Evil's first review. See you next time for the Game Boy Color.